Ram Madhav ji, you compared Rohingyas with illegal Bangladeshis, saying that Bangladesh has a similar problem. The advisor to the Bangladeshi Prime Minister strongly disagreeing, saying that there is no comparison. On one side, there's ethnic cleansing and genocide. On the other is a question about nationality, and therefore you can't compare the two. Perceptions very opposed on both sides of the border.
Oh, yes. In fact, you also should not compare the two. So we have to deal with Rohingyas differently, and we have to deal with other infiltrators differently. We are not having any NRC for Rohingyas, my friend. NRC is a process that we are following in the case of other infiltrators, because they're different. We know what he's saying. I fully agree with him.
Nice. It's good to see India, Bangladesh, Bonhomie. That's the one neighbor with whom we still have an equation which is in order, and thank God for that. Tell us, Dr. Rizvi, you have 6.5 lakh Rohingyas who crossed over just over the past few months. Before that, over several years, 3.5 lakh Rohingyas crossed over into Bangladesh, leading to a number of about 1 million or so. How does Bangladesh intend to deal with Rohingyas living on your soil?
The immediate burden of hosting and looking after 1 million Rohingyas has fallen on our shoulder. And I think our Prime Minister has shown to the world what a humanitarian gesture should look like. We are not a wealthy country. We are probably the most densely populated country in the world. But her statement in the parliament is, we will share our meals with them. We will eat half the meal and we will give them the other half. So that was their gesture that our Prime Minister showed. But the problem is not entirely Bangladesh's. It's a global problem. It is the whole world's responsibility to ensure that these Rohingyas are repatriated back to their homes, to their land, to their family, to their country. And happily, India itself is one of our major allies that is helping and facilitating the process.
Are you then disappointed? You're calling this a global problem. Are you then disappointed, Dr. Rizvi, that India, a country arguably richer and bigger than Bangladesh, is not showing the same kind of compassion and sharing means as a country like Bangladesh, which is smaller and less affluent?
I don't think I want to go to comment on that. And I don't know which population you are referring to. But as far as Rohingyas are concerned, it is a global problem. Because let us pause for one moment. If we start accepting genocidal deportation of a minority, where do we draw the line? Today, there is not a single state in the world which is homogeneous. We are all heterogeneous, multinational, multi-ethnic, multilingual, multi-religious. If we then say, okay, one ethnic group or one religious group we are going to deport, it is a problem of the whole world. You cannot unscramble a scrambled egg. And that is precisely the nature of this population movement.
So you're calling this genocidal deportation, essentially raising questions about the safety of these Rohingyas when they go back to their country.
And that is why we are not pushing them back. We are saying they must go, and we are building up international opinion to send them back. So but we are at the same time saying that they will only go back voluntarily, and they will go back when the conditions in Myanmar are such that they can go back and lead a safe life.
I must say, Dr. Rizvi, you're a terrific trapeze artist. You're saying everything that needs to be said and couching it in a manner that, you know, doesn't create any diplomatic problem. But let me ask you a question.
I'm a very clumsy person.
You're a very good trapeze artist. What do you make of the deportation of 7 Rohingyas from the Moray border in Manipur in India's northeast? You're saying that you have to wait till the conditions in Myanmar are such that it doesn't lead to genocidal deportation. The Indian government just sent 7 Rohingyas back. What does the government in Bangladesh make of that?
Now, I don't know. Mr. Madhav might be able to tell us that. But my sense is India would have never sent them back unless it got an assurance from Myanmar of their safety, of their security, and of their well-being. This is my feeling, I have no knowledge.
Did we get such an assurance, Ram Madhavji?
Their identities were ascertained on both sides, then only they were sent across the borders.
No, I think his question is different. Of course, the identities were ascertained. Are we certain that once they go back to Myanmar, they'll be safe and they'll not be part of the genocide?
Yeah, that's what he is also saying. We should put pressure on the Myanmar government to ensure that the safety and security of the people of their country is taken
care
of.
The government in Myanmar or the army in Myanmar doesn't want them. It says these people don't belong in our country. We don't want them.
That is not true.
Therefore, the fear that they get killed.
I'm sure Mr. Rizvi has not said that. You are putting words in his mouth.
No, he said it. He is not saying that. That the army in Myanmar has made clear that it doesn't want any Rohingyas on their soil.
No, it is, what I'm saying is it is a systematic genocidal attempt to push an entire ethnic community out of the country. And this is not only morally and ethically wrong, but no country in the world should accept this, because it would set a precedence whereby any country which it doesn't like, you remember not very long ago, what did Idi Amin do? He pushed an entire community out. Can we allow such things to happen? No. And that is why India, Bangladesh, as much as EU and United States have equal responsibility in ensuring that people of Rohingya origin who are of Myanmar national, they should go back to their homes. And that's the whole challenge for the international community.